Hello, my name is Scott Weichler. I'm the Deputy Fire Chief at the Strasburg Volunteer Fire Company. And we're here today to talk about our new Pierce Enforcer PUC Pumper. Strasburg Fire Company, we selected Pierce. We have a Pierce ladder truck in our station currently. It's a 2008 Pierce PUC Quint. It was the first ladder PUC built by Pierce. So we're very proud that we have number one. And so we were very interested in pursuing Pierce because that piece has served us very well over the years. One of the reasons we chose the PUC was because of the available compartment space that it does give you over a traditional pumper. This piece will be a rescue pumper, so we'll have fire suppression as well as vehicle rescue capabilities. So we needed the extra compartment space to hold the various pieces of tools and equipment that we needed to accomplish our goals. The other reason we chose the PUC pump is the ease of use and the reliability of it, as well as our truck is PUC, and it reduces the training time. When we have a driver train on one piece and move to the next piece, the pump is essentially the same, and it'll be very easy for the operators to go from one to the other and operate the pump efficiently. As we go through this, you'll see we did on the front bumper, we have a closed compartment. We're gonna put one of our battery-operated rescue tools on the front just for efficiency of getting it to a vehicle accident if needed. There's also a trash line that will be under there and a front intake suction so we can draft. Much of our first new area is non-hydrated, so we need to be able to draft from a static water supply as needed. So this gives us an option of nosing into a static water supply. As we go around, we can, in the back, in the crew compartment, we did go with an additional seat. So we have seating for five instead of the traditional four, just to get more firefighters to the scene with air packs to help with suppression activities. We did go with the crosslays behind the door here on the speed trays, which we really like this feature of Pierce. It helps. We have some extra trays so we can preload the hose in those. So after calls, especially in the early morning hours, we can get the piece back into a service very quickly and get our firefighters back to bed so they can get up and go to their paid jobs that most of us have on the outside. And then just looking at our pump panel, this pump panel is virtually identical to what's on our ladder truck. So again, it will make it very easy for someone to train on both pieces simultaneously and understand the operation of the pump and be able to do so very quickly. And then just as you go around, you'll just see the size of the compartments. They're all very deep, with the exception of the ones on the driver's side because of the ladder tunnel. But the compartments are very deep, they're very large, so we can get an awful, you know, quite a bit of tools and equipment in them that we will need again, as this piece will both be fire suppression and provide rescue capabilities for vehicle accidents and other incidents. One of the other things we do like about this vehicle has the TAC-4 suspension, which does make this vehicle very easy to drive. While it's a very large piece, it drives very small, if that makes sense, that it is an easy piece to operate. And our truck, again, is a TAC-4 suspension. So for our operators, our drivers, this should be a fairly easy step over to drive this piece as well. And just going through, I can open up the compartments. You can see the size of them. And then we did, of course, go over with the wheel well SCBA storage on all around all the wheels on the rear. So we have four areas to put extra air cylinders. And again, another very large compartment. You can see it's a pass-through compartment, but very large. And coming around to the rear, we did put a large diameter discharge in the rear so that we can get water, distribute water to either our ladder truck or another company, if we're in a relay. So that was convenient. And then, of course we have our ground ladders here, which are the required NFPA. And then up top, we have a compartment for a Stokes basket. And then on either side, the smaller compartments would be for our hard sleeve for our drafting operation. So we will have two 15-foot sections, which will give us 30 feet of hard sleeve for drafting operations. Now coming around to the officer side, the compartments do get a little bigger, a little deeper because we don't have a ladder tunnel. And then you can see here, we have a tube here. This goes actually up to a coffin compartment on top where we have an oil dry hopper. And then we can, underneath the oil dry comes through. So we will be able to carry about 200 pounds of oil dry for vehicle accidents on this instead of a traditional 5-gallon bucket or two. So we'll have more ability to clean up spills at a vehicle accident scene. And then as we continue down, just to show you the depths and the size of the compartments, we did add electrical receptacles to this compartment and one other one. With many of our tools now going to batteries, we wanted to have additional charging capabilities for our portable tools and batteries. And all of these receptacles are wired to the onboard generator so that we can charge our tools or our batteries while we're on calls instead of just on the shoreline when we're at the station. And again, continuing down, another very large compartment. We'll probably end up putting our rescue tools in here. And then lastly, this large compartment, which again has two areas of receptacles to further enhance our abilities to charge many of our battery operated tools, you know, whether it be Sawzalls, our ventilation fans and other things. We do have a 6 kV generator on the top, which supplies our two cord reels. And again, is wired to provide power to the receptacles on here so we can charge all of our pieces or all of our batteries while we're on a call. So you can see we did go with a full NFPA compliant light system. It's all LED, so they're very bright. It doesn't draw a lot of amperage. We did put the road array on the front just to further, again, alert people that we're coming. We do have a federal cue siren, and we do have train horns underneath. Part of the train horns was on, you know, they're loud, but Strasburg, Pennsylvania is known as Train Town USA. We have one of the oldest steam-driven railroad stations. That's a tourist attraction, so we wanted to kind of combine that. If you saw our patch as we walked around, you saw the train on it. So we will be able to alert people that, hey, we're coming, and so that, you know, gives the community advanced warning to get out of our way so we can respond to our emergency efficiently. So that's our new 2023 Pearson Forcer Puck Pumper. We would like to say thank you to Pierce. They've been great to work with, made the process of designing this and bringing it to fruition very easy. And special thanks to Jake Bachman, our salesman from Glick Fire Apparatus in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. Yeah, Jake was a member of this fire company as a junior firefighter at 14. He's moved on to another fire company, a community where he and his wife live. However, it was really great to work with Jake as a former member to bring this fire truck to Strasburg and work with an old friend and an old brother firefighter to make it happen. So thank you.